That'd be very good, bro. You're gonna have to go with it.
But it's a famous one.
It, they filmed it here, so it's all this hype in Dubrovnik about Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
And this is our business part of the city. Today it's a working day. It's I guess Wednesday. And so working hours are like 7:30 till 3:30 for public sector and like 8 till 4 for private sector.
Yeah. Okay.
And so then it's
7:30 in the morning.
Yes, but because you know the sun rises earlier here, you know.
Yeah.
Like for example, you are from England and then in your, let's say on your like meridian it's France.
Yeah.
But then Spain is even west of England. And it's still, they have the same Central European time zone, you know. But then in France, you know, the sun rises later, much later than here, but also sets later. And then everything starts at 9. Mm. And here it's like 7:30, it's normal, you know. But this is like this administration, governmental offices and so on.
Mm-hmm.
And 8 is for banks, for shops and so on.
Right.
This is the, we have an office here to the right. And this is the new bay, it's the new port of Dubrovnik, located in this long bay. So this is the port area, it's called Gruž, and across it's a residential peninsula, it's called Lapad, L-A-P-A-D.
Lapad,
yeah.
So that's Lapad.
If you have more time, you know, in
Dubrovnik.
It's
a good place to visit?
Yes, to go by bus number 6, you know.
Whoa. Why would you come running?
Yeah, come on.
Wow.
Like nobody sees you coming running.
Wow, out the alleyways.
Out the alleyways, yes, how are you supposed to see
you? Kids only drive slowly, you know, so it's... you have to be careful.
Safety, yeah.
But it's a full run, you know.
Yeah, full
this
run,
is beautiful.
Like, it's crazy, kid.
So it's just kids, you know.
Yeah.
So, but
that's how you die, is it?
Yes, that's why I know why you are freaking out because you are looking.
Kids.
Yes. I'm still like on a planning mode, you know.
Good luck with that.
Thanks. So this is the marketplace, green and fruits and vegetables market. Then our fish market in the back. Then this is the port area where all these boats for local islands go and hydrofoil across the so different cruises and we have about 800,000 people coming from cruise ships to Dubrovnik every year.
This
is this is Regent. So Regent is the most luxury cruise company, one of the most luxury companies that come here. Regent, I guess it's Seven Seas. I think it's called Seven Seas Mariner. And this is all suites. So every room is a suite with
Seven
Explorer.
Seven Seas.
So this one, this is like top us upscale.
Top level,
top level where everything is
high level. Yeah.
You have the all the. You live there, but not for a long time. You live there for a week or 2 weeks.
Mm. So like now, when you go to sleep, the ship goes to a different country. When you wake up, you're somewhere different.
Yes,
it's a good way of visiting lots of destinations,
especially when you're with kids. You know, because then often you have like discounts or free, you know, birds for kids. You know, and then you don't have to carry all the stuff out, and then you just go out at the destination and come back. You know?
They have like 51% are
Bosnian. Kids enjoying
Muslims,
the tour.
17%
enjoying the tour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You dock your boats.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Car park for boats. You know. Great. So this is all small boats where you can take the boat out and then you can go through the islands, sail, and you have a captain who is taking you, and you are just enjoying the sun and the wind in your hair. So that's good. Croatian coast, you know, we call our coast the land of 1,000 islands.
Okay.
Because there is so many little islands, hidden coasts, you know, and then you can choose if you go, let's say, family, you rent a boat for a week with a skipper, and then you can choose whether each night you want to be in more urban spot like Dubrovnik, where you have all the entertainment, or you want to stay in some small village where a fisherman owns their own, you know, restaurant, and then he serves his own catch, you know.
So it's quite local sort of community you have?
Yes.
Regular life.
You choose, you know, what you want. Or you just want to be on your own in some secluded cove and then you cook on board for yourself. Wow, and there is cool. Nobody else, just the moonlight and the water and you, you know. So that's
nice.
All.
That's nice. Man.
That's why, you know, there it's something for everybody here.
That's the problem.
That's what you walk now with the Nera, that's the old town.
Oh,
that's
no, old. We just went around in a circle.
Yeah, we went around just to see a little bit more. You
of
know,
the local of the, city.
Yes, of panorama and all. And now...
It's very beautiful.
Thank you. It's my neighborhood, you know. And in front of the city here you have that island. Island is called Lokrum Island.
Lokrum.
And Lokrum is supposed to be a cursed island.
Oh, really?
So why cursed? Because for 700 years there were monks of Saint Benedict's order living on the island, and these Benedictine monks, they were like a secluded order. They did not go to the city much. City respected that. It was a nice coexistence between the two. And then in 18th century, Dubrovnik was in big financial difficulties, and then one of the solutions how to raise the money was to sell the island. And selling the island meant that the monks would have to move, and they did not want to move, so there was a big struggle between the church and the state, and then the church lost and monks were evicted. And then the story goes that last night before they were evicted, that all 18 monks walked alongside the island all night long with their candlesticks upside down, chanting some dark tunes, and then because by the end of the night they put a curse on the island, so that whoever owns the island, or for whoever would be in charge of selling the island, would die a non-natural death.
Wow.
And then we have records of everybody who owned the island later and what happened to them. So there was number of bizarre accidents, deaths, suicides, murders, which you can say this is the curse, or you can say this is the crazy nobles who would have killed them.
Are we going to take a walk through Cavtat?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Savtat. Savtat.
C-A-V-T-A-T.
Savtat.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, I'm trying to learn the language. I still need to learn hello and thank you.
Hvala is thank you. H-V-A-L-A.
Hvala.
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 Yeah. It's like saying voila.
Yes, but just it? With a H.
Hvala.
Hvala. Hvala. Hvala. And then... please is molim, you know,
molim.
Like can you give me something, please, this molim pivo, molim vodu.
Okay, and hello?
Hello, it's tricky because we don't normally use it. You say, if it's informal, then you say bok.
Bok.
Bok. But if it's formal, then you say dobar dan.
Dobar dan
means good day.
I'm recording all this, so I'll look back and remember.
Bok.
Bok.
Bok. Bok, bok.
I'm practicing my Croatian.
Oh, good, good.
Guys.
Bok, bok.
And there's mummy on the phone there, going through her little pictures. Kiddos, are you having a good time?
Yeah.
Are you enjoying seeing Croatia?
Yeah.
Yes.
Dubrovnik? Beautiful, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Right,
I would
great
actually
time.
Move here, seriously.
Good. She wants to move here. She, there's another country on the list.
Yes.
Good, good, good.
She's,
few months, you know, because...
That's what I said to him.
London is not so far away, you know.
She's trying to change my life, guys.
I'm trying to...
I like London.
I want to try...
I like London. She's trying to change my life.
I'm trying to get...
You have a lot of low costs, so you're here a little bit, then home a little bit, you know.
Yes, yes, yes. The only thing here will be work.
Well,
what would you do for a job here?
Yes, but I mean, you would have to be in tourism in some way. Or another, marketing, tourism.
She's all right,
so
because she does online business now.
Yes,
so
yes.
But you need
as long
to,
as you can,
I don't know how expensive
get your stock.
It is to
live here. Yeah.
But well, it,
what's the cost of living here?
Depends what you count. So like, let's say a flat would cost you about £500 per month. You know, a good flat.
How many bedrooms?
Two bedrooms.
Okay. Yeah,
but that's a good flat. You know, £500 plus you pay about £100 are utilities.
Right.
120.
The thing
maybe.
Is, you wouldn't live in the city walls. You would live outside the city walls.
No, you don't want to live in the city walls because it's just too crowded.
Too crowded.
And so I'll continue on this. So what you'll do? You will just get out, please, here, and wait for me 2-3 minutes until I park the car, and then I will be.
Okay, we've just jumped out of the ride, man.
Yeah. our driver is just gonna go park.
So we're in the historical city of Kaftak. So this is another part of our tour.
We're just gonna go see what's here.
So we're gonna just have this is the beautiful city of Kaftak.
Yeah. I'm trying to get Jazz to move here for 3 months.
Don't forget something. Get you.
You'll be so happy.
It looks then. So beautiful here, isn't it?
Yeah,
vinegar. All vinegar put it. It's antiseptic.
Right, Ben? Ben, what do you get?
Bye bye.
Let's stop that. Huh? What do you think, Ben?
It does look nice here, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does, isn't it?
It reminds me of Hout Bay in
In you know Cape Town. What I like about this place?
Yeah. What do you like about it? Tell me.
I like that it's still old because you can still like see the old building and it's still rustic, but it's comfortable and nice at the same time. Because like sometimes places are too modern.
Finn,
come here. Finn, come and hold my hand. You know, like sometimes places are too modern and too overbuilt, and this one you get a bit of everything, and it's really nice.
Babe, I was gonna say your necklace and your bracelets look awesome.
Are they popping?
We haven't seen your bracelets.
Yeah, they're popping.
Look at those bracelets, man.
Look at that, man.
Royal head wraps.
Yeah, you like them, Finn.
Royal African jewelry now, by the looks of it.
Royal African jewelry. You know that. I'll hook you up, guys. Don't worry. Amazon coming.
Small ones.
Are they still tiny?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Finn, they're still tiny. They're not ready yet.
Yeah.
They're not ready to eat yet.
Ready. Taken out.
And do they do lots of fishing here? Or?
Yes. I go also spear fishing.
Oh, really? Oh, spear fishing?
Yes, with the mask and the fins.
Wow.
And so on.
And you catch anything good?
Yeah, well, I catch enough for dinner every time.
Oh, wow.
Like
okay.
Sea bass or grouper.
Yeah. Or sea bass, really? Octopus, ew! Do you eat it?
I take it as blessings, isn't it?
Yeah. The nun loves Swin's hair and Havana's hair. Ah, say thank you for us.
You can see she's a girl, you know how she behaves.
Yes.
And so on, you know.
Get me a snout. No!
He's gonna eat her up.
That means yummy, yummy.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
Unbelievable.
Not just from the top.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. I'll bring you another
tissue.